You know, headwinds are fascinating, and I love this idea of your theme being ascend. How does an aircraft ascend? It turns into its headwinds, right? Beautifully, unapologetically, and in pure acceptance, and launches into the air, right? That's how we ascend, by turning into headwinds. So I'm going to tell a very personal story, and sometimes it's kind of hard for me to tell because I want to be vulnerable with all of you. I think hopefully the last year has taught us to be a lot more vulnerable with each other. And I think that hopefully this story is a reminder that humanity has a place in your workplace, and for all of us to keep humanity in the workplace. And I share this story with a deep humility, knowing that there are people right now watching this, you, who've endured similar or more difficult things, or love somebody who has. So look at that picture in front of you. That's my husband, Paul. We'll be married 20 years in October. My twins, Garrick and Nora, who are happily upstairs on an iPad, thankful to you that they get an hour of iPad time. And also, that's just a picture of us when we used to live in Washington, D.C. And as I look at this picture, I think to myself, you know, what gives my life meaning? What gives your life meaning? Who are you outside of work? Who are you outside of all the labels that society places on you? What is it that you individually value? It's so important for you to know what gives your life meaning. And the reason is, when the headwinds come along, when the headwinds come along while you're trying to ascend to that next goal or on that next adventure, if you know what it is that gives your life meaning, just like an aircraft, it makes it easier, more efficient, and smoother to endure those headwinds when they come along. So here's my story. People ask me, Nicole, your career was awesome. Like, I was listening to Eric's bio on you. It sounded pretty good. Why aren't you still in the military? Right? That's a great question. And I'd love to still be in the military as much as I love being here with you right now. If I could be out there wearing my nation's uniform, flying that beautiful F-15E and leading airmen on an elite performing team, honestly, that's where I'd be. But the fact of the matter is that 3 years ago, a big headwind came along in my personal life just when I was ascending to new heights. It came along and it knocked me down. I fell unexpectedly severely ill, and out of nowhere, overnight, I was medically retired from the career that I loved after being found, quote, 100% unfit for duty due to my illness. Yeah, overnight, this really, you know, amazing fighter pilot. I was physically fit, mentally fit, spiritually fit, was completely broken. Overnight, I lost my identity as an officer in the Air Force. Overnight, I lost my profession as a fighter pilot. Overnight, I lost my means of providing for my family. You see, in the summer of 2012, I was the commander of an F-15E fighter squadron. That's right. The highlight and privilege of my career was commanding an F-15E fighter squadron. It was me and 100 totally amazing, patriotic, type A, highly skillful, elite, professional, macho men, and it was good to be the queen. And we were having a good time. And in the summer of 2012, I started to feel sick, like I had the flu, little fever, little malaise, joint pain, and I had a rash on my hip too. And I went to the doctor, which is hard for pilots to do. We don't like to go to the doctors, right? Because we're afraid they're going to ground us and not let us fly. But I finally just hadn't been feeling well for like 2 weeks. And I went to the doctor and I said, I'm sick. He took a look at me. He took a look at my rash. He said, it's a spider bite. Gave me some topical ointment, told me to rest and to hydrate. Well, unfortunately, it wasn't a spider bite. Over the next 3 months, my symptoms would rapidly worsen to include very scary neurological symptoms. I started having pins and needles and numbness down the right side of my body. I had a lack of coordination with my right hand. I would sometimes trip and drag my right leg. I had struggles with reading and writing. I started having problems with word finding, stuttering and slurring my words. I also had problems with both short and long-term memory. As you can imagine, for a fighter pilot at the height of their career, this is very terrifying and scary. The doctors in the military did the best they could, but I was a bit of a medical mystery. So I forged ahead, knowing that I would never fly an aircraft again, but saying, hey, I've had a good flying career. I can still be part of this Air Force team, and I can still lead airmen. Unfortunately, as I endured that over the next 4 years, my symptoms would continue to flare. Very randomly, very unpredictable, they would wax and wane. And my symptom list grew to, well, at the end of the 4 years, I had about 63 different symptoms impacting every system in my body. I saw the best of military medicine and the best of civilian medicine until the summer of 2016, when I was serving in the White House as the military aide to then First Lady Michelle Obama, I woke up in my bed and I was locked in. I couldn't move. I was paralyzed. I couldn't walk or talk. It was terrifying until my husband found me. At that point, the Air Force cut bait and they shifted me up to Boston, Massachusetts, where I was accurately diagnosed and started my recovery. My career, this amazing career, was gone in the blink of a bite. I'm a no-joke survivor of late-stage neurological tick-borne illness. A tick bite ended my career. For the next 9 months, I laid in bed with a caregiver and a home health care nurse, unable to walk, talk, read, or write. I spent the next year learning how to walk, talk, read, and write to be here in front of you. And during that time, the Air Force did what they had to do, and that was medically retire me. So when people ask me, Nicole, how did you go from fighter pilot to professional speaker? The answer, my friends, is I have 9 months worth of words saved up and I am still trying to get them out. Okay. All right. But seriously, I stand in front of you as someone who's a walking poster child of invisible illness. I still cannot read and write. I have major autonomic nervous system issues. And in a cruel twist of fate, I have a balance deficit that makes me get motion sick on aircraft and in vehicles. Yeah, that's funny. That's just the universe keeping me, you know, straight. But here's the thing. People say, Nicole, you're so resilient. Resilience is important. Resilience is when mistakes and failures and bumps happen and you fall down and you bounce back to your old self. But sometimes we go through crucible experiences, like the one I just shared, or the whole last year that you and I have gone through, that fundamentally changes and shifts who we are. I'm not resilient because there's no bouncing back to my old self. My old self is gone. I'm forged into something because of this headwind that's bigger, better, more compassionate, stronger, and able to ascend to different levels. I hope the same for all of you. I tell people I'm not resilient, I'm resurgent. I have harnessed this headwind in a way to ascend to a different level, and I believe that all of you can too. Every single one of us has the power to reinvent ourselves at any given time.